Welcome to Kia e-Niro Diaries and my rather stylish hat, don't you think? Anyway, we had some problems with the car and it wouldn't charge DC. And we left it with a dealer on Friday. Today is Wednesday, the 4th of December. So they had it for a few days. They were scratching their heads. They couldn't figure out what was wrong. Then they found that another one of their cars also wouldn't charge DC. And it turns out, after a bit of investigation, that all of the chargers in the area around Neor, which are run by a company called Ciolis, wouldn't work with Kia and Jaguars. So it's a software problem. So we were really worried about this because we are now en route to the UK. We're north of Tours, somewhere between Tours and Le Mans. So we stopped at this charger. It's supposed to be 50 kilowatt DC. It's actually only given us 20, but anyway, here we are, and it works. So there was nothing to worry about. I just didn't have the car for, four or five days, which is a bit of an inconvenience because we had to drive one of those things that you had to put petrol in and all that. So anyway, we're en route to the UK. It's a cold, sunny day. Look at this. It's quarter to five in the afternoon. So it'll be getting dark soon, and we will soon be making our way up to Wistrem to get the ferry across to Portsmouth, and we should get into Portsmouth early tomorrow morning. So hopefully we'll have enough range to get then to where we're going in the UK. Good. So another thing to mention, we are regular users of Brittany Ferries, and we've asked them several times, why don't you allow electric cars to charge on the boat, because that would be a fairly cheap and simple thing to set up. There's lots of power being generated on those massive diesel engines. While we're asleep in our cabin, you'd think it would be a perfect thing, but nope, they don't do it. So we're going to have to hopefully grab a bit more charge. We'll need to get on a slow charger. There's some AC 7 kilowatt chargers around the port, so when we get up there in about 3 hours time, we will plug in and hopefully get on. But please, Brittany Ferries, put electric vehicle charging on your ferries, please. Kia e-Niro Diaries on the wrong side of the road. First time of driving in the UK on our trip. Currently heading north to Buckingham on the A34. Just plugged in at Sainsbury's in Winchester and got about 100 kilometres of free, which was nice. Free is always good. So this is my first time back in the UK for exactly a year to the day we came in on the Thursday the 5th. Today is Sunday the 8th. And my impressions are that it hasn't changed much. The roads vary from being nice and smooth to being bumpy and full of potholes. And then there's these ridges across the road that the car keeps bumping on, which we just don't get in France on the main roads. They just don't seem to maintain the roads to the same standard. But hey, it's always been that way. Lived most of my life here, so I know what I'm in for. And it's just so crowded, loads of cars everywhere, and not a lot of road space. It seems a bit narrow. Charging, no problem so far. And we hope up in Buckingham we're going to be able to get on a 50 kilowatt charger just around the corner from the hotel where we're staying, so that should be good. And look, the sun is shining! Coming up towards Newbury, and so bye for now. Now at Tesco's in Buckingham, where there's a 4 plug-in points, 7.2 kilowatt mid-level chargers. Just been doing some shopping, grabbing some essentials like tea. So nice shiny new pod. point chargers, just like the ones at Sainsbury's in Winchester, just scavenging for power, which is a great way to go, because this is all 3 kilometres. And there we go, a little bit of advertising for the ID3. And the Volkswagen sign, this is how it works. Very simple, just plug in. Now I'm going to unplug. Got that. So, I've arrived at the Ionity charger on the A84, somewhere between Le Mans and Samur, not far from Samur now. Nice, neat setup here. There are 4 spaces. I was down to 18% charge, about 50 kilometres left. Going into the wind, it's very cold. It's not quite as rainy as it was further north at Alençon. Very, very easy to use. You just go around the front here. Around the back. So basically, it's just the CCS combo option. That's all there is. Nice big screen. Takes you through the how to go about this. I just plug straight in, and then press the buttons, wave my card in front of it. It says it's exchanging information with the car, and then when it's happy, off it goes. Slightly disappointed in that the e-Niro is supposed to be able to take 100 kilowatt charge, and some people in the UK have said they've seen 77 on a 100 kilowatt charger. I'm only getting 52 here, but still it's going to be pretty quick, and I need a break. Done about 250 kilometres, got another couple of 100 kilometres, and this will be my last stop. It's 11 o'clock in the morning, and I came off the ferry at about 10 past 7. So there we go. Very nice Ionity chargers. Perhaps as we see more of these, we won't feel like second-class citizens, those of us who don't drive a Tesla. So back to the car after an excellent lunch. It's been about an hour. And it's got 1% to go. I noticed the charging rate slowed down as it gets close to, I set it at 90% for DC charging as the maximum, and it was say it was 53 kilowatts when it started. It's down to 23, and it's delivered 51 kilowatt hours. So, Mrs. e-Niro stayed in the UK. She's on a mission. I don't know what she does. She said she could tell me, but she'd have to kill me. But anyway, she's in London today, so I've had to drive back on my own. So, just taking it easy, no real rush. It's lunchtime, it's 12 o'clock now. So another couple of hours, and won't have to stop for charging again. So Ionity then, way to go. Another 3 sort of things with Ionity written on it, and there's one with a Shell sign and Ionity written on it. There's no charging posts here, but there's a car charging sign. So maybe they're going to expand this. There's four posts at the moment, but there's seven bays. So, yeah, interesting. I wouldn't have thought it's one of the busiest routes in France, but anyway, Ionity, great stuff. So after a few days driving on those terrible English roads, it's nice to be back in France. This is not a particularly main road. After charging up at the Ionity charger, just decided I'd had enough of auto routes. Done 300 kilometres, 315, about another 125 to go. So this is the back road from Saumur to Poitiers. I had the displeasure of driving from Buckingham to Milton Keynes last week, and it's like, oh my goodness, this is an A road in the UK, and the potholes, the ridges, no wonder people's suspensions get wrecked over there. So on these roads I'm making between 75 and 90 kilometres an hour, but my consumption going into the wind on a cold day at about 110, 115 kilometres an hour on the auto route, my consumption had gone up almost to 22 kilowatt hours, 100 kilometres, and it's steadily dropping back down again. I've got the heater on just on the driver's side, which is supposed to save a bit of energy. It'll be interesting to see what it is when I get home after I've been driving at these slower speeds for a bit longer.